There are some verses from the Quran, subhanAllah, if you read them, you know, it's like fully blessed with guidance. You know, many people who have never read the Quran before, they will just flip those particular verses and they will be really amazed what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying. That's like guidance is filled in it. The words itself has a lot of wisdom in it and a lot of guidance in it. But apart from that, there is additional blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that it has an effect on the listener, that it impacts the person, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can potentially guide that person. If that person is sincere in his heart, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed such a thing in those verses that it will guide that person to it. It will make at least easy for that person to be guided. So that's the special blessing. So that's why we have to recite the Quran as much as possible, and different chapters and everything, complete A to Z. And even subhanAllah, regardless of the religion, we see even Muslims who are very, like maybe even scholars, sometimes they read a verse, open a Quran, they have probably read it like 50, 100 times. And when they read that verse, subhanAllah, it gives like a completely different interpretation to them. They're like, subhanAllah, I read this so many times, but I never thought it this way. So why? Because what's happening here? Because that blessing, the blessing here is what? The guidance is coming to you from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the impact that it has. So regardless of what state of your iman you have, there are some verses that can impact you. And that's why you have to get that blessing. And sometimes we don't even understand the verse, but you know, you feel it sometimes that there's something in this verse, you know, I have to change my life now. I have to change my life. There's something in this verse that is telling you, you know, that you have to, that's it, you know, that you have to change your life. You have to stop doing this, start doing this. It's time that I worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the degree that He wants. So that is the reason why we should read the entire Quran. We'll now focus what I was mentioning about the blessing itself in the Holy Quran. So, what are the blessings in the Quran? I just mentioned few of them. So, first of all, what is the meaning of blessing? When do we say something has a blessing? I mean, in general terms, you know, when we say something is blessed, we basically mean that two things. There is a favor. I mean, a person is getting benefited by something, well, the thing that he's blessed with. So it's a favor. And in terms of Quran, if you look, there are two things. Allah's favor will be upon you. He will benefit you with something. And it can also be in the form of protection. The benefit can be in the form of protection. So there is benefit and there is protection. So Allah protects you from things that can harm you. So there are two. That's what blessing is about, as we all know. So entire Quran, fully, completely, is blessed. No portion of it can you say that this is not blessed. No, because this is kalam of Allah. This book that you're seeing here, this is not a book of a human being. It's not a speech of human being. It's not a writing of human being. It is word for word revealed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam delivered it to us. That's what it is. It is not authored by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It is flawless. It is eloquent. You cannot get any word structure better than what we have here. And I told this last time as well, that the scholars of Quran, you know, those who have done like extensive research and extensive study, they said that if you take any verse from the Holy Quran and you try to replace any word with a different word, the overall meaning, the structure of that word, you know, the value goes down. But that's the beauty of the Quran. And so one of those who understand Arabic very well, they can tell you, you know, people who read the translations, they lose a lot of stuff. They lose a lot of stuff because you can never translate few things. You can just give a rough meaning in the translation, but that whole flow, that rhythm, it's lost in translation. So, you know, whenever we get opportunity, we should, you know, the institutes throughout New York and everywhere, try this, you know, learn these basic Arabic grammar and rules. That will benefit us a lot. You know, and try to understand it. There are a few words which everybody knows, you know, Jannah, Nar, Ghafoor, Rahim. These things, when you listen, these often repeated words, you can get the context of the verse that you are listening to. So that's one thing. And